Every stream with this.
Alright.
Oh, goodness. Yeah, I do the announcement and stuff, I guess.
Welcome back to the fucking 20th day of Silence Brand.
Silence Brand. And this? There we go.
Very well done.
Yes, I'm actually remembering. Don't worry, I'll forget something, though. Always love this, like, opening music.
Boy.
Don't we. That's gonna be a chill one. Also, do you... How far are we into Shining Force 2? We just got... we beat the Titan. There's a Titan, and I got to a port town, and there were like two people that forced their way into my party. And we got something called the Caravan, which makes us super small, but we can go long distances and stuff.
It's also basically your base on wheels.
Oh, okay, that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Thank you. A lovely boyfriend just came in with a couple of burritos because I have not eaten dinner yet. So.
Anyways.
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to rub it in.
I'll break both of your arms, your legs, and then eat.
Me sitting here wondering if that is arousing or not. Ah, the return of the Y boner.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of enjoy the music right now before I really get into it.
You're just stoned and you don't want them to know.
You know, maybe. Nah, I've never done a weed. Not once in my life. Though it might help me with, you know, my incredible anxiety. But also, you guys may notice that I now have a bot in the chat, so it should shout people out when they raid and give you guys links to their stuff, because I've been wanting to, spread the love back to all the wonderful people that raid. And so I figured that shit out last time. Hoping the bot works. But only time will tell with that one, I guess. Let's see, it's not good. Will our hapless hero manage to play Shining Force 2 without exiting the game? Oh, man. Really good question.
That honestly is.
It is a struggle, more so than anyone realizes.
Could perhaps maybe borrowing a brain cell from someone help you?
Maybe. Maybe.
You ain't gonna get one from me. If you take my last one, I die.
Well. I will not take that then. But we will see just how bad it is. Oh, hold on. I gotta fade us in. Oh, wow. That's not set up correctly at all. Hold on. I knew I was gonna forget something. Crap. Okay, hold on.
Everybody's favorite microprocessor without the processor or the micro, Daniel Bandicoot struggling to figure out how to operate his fucking Twitch stream for the 83rd time.
It's incredible, right? You would think that I would have this shit figured out by now.
Ben Shapiro's lost twin, Daniel Bandicoot, struggling in vain to figure out how to start his stream without it being an hour late.
Hold on, why is that still...
So in tasting, what we do is take a small amount right off the top. Doesn't take much. That's the warmest part right here. I'm going to invert the spoon. Cover all 9,000 taste buds.
You were saying.
Aerate it. Warm it up. Grabbing up. And top note.
Oh my gosh. Thank you, Neymar, for the gift sub. There we go. We're all good now. Please, Dandy has at least 30 pounds on Shapiro. You know, a good point.
All yeah, right. But it's like 30 pounds of dick.
You know what? I mean, it's still something, right? Maybe. I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying.
I don't know. I think Dandy could probably easily out debate Ben Shapiro. It wouldn't take too much. Yeah.
Okay, so I know we're in the back in the game. We're back here in Shining Force in this lovely, wonderful port town. I've completely forgotten what our objective is right now. Whoops, that's not what I want to do. Stop.
God. You've bought a bunch of new shit.
Mm-hmm.
You now have access to go and do things you couldn't do before. Like drive over those rocky stone paths.
Ooh. Wait, where's the caravan at?
It kind of follows you around like a weird-looking malformed child.
Mmm. Let's go up here. Oh, I can't go over this, can I?
That is what the caravan is for.
How do I use it?
Go back down to that area where you just were that would let you walk on that and then go left, you putz.
Oh, wait.
No, just go up. There you go. Yeah, okay. Up. With your legs. There you go. There you go. Now he's doing it. Almost
I'm doing
there.
It!
Oh my god! Oh my god! Holy shit!
Boy! I did it.
Dandy, every time you fuck up, 30 people die. I just want to let you know that.
I am the sole source of death in the world, then, because I fuck up a lot.
Look at that fireplace, loser. Hey, loser, look at that fireplace.
I will. Came from Grange to look for mithril.
There you go.
Dry stone!
Much like my humor, that stone is exceptionally dry.
Recent earthquakes have buried the tunnel. Parents, check now. We can't dig the tunnel without him.
And Andy, you know what your Twitch stream probably loves? The sound of you scarfing food.
Oh, I hope it's like blocked out on stream.
Yeah, it's totally blocked out as Danny's like. Everybody's into it. They're feeling it.
So sorry. Boring some more. I mean, some people might be into that. Cold. Oh, I'm so cold. One of us went to look for the fairy. I hope he's all right.
Resident weirdo Daniel Bandicoot forgetting to say hi to one of his boyfriends as his relationships dissolve in real time.
Hi, hon. Well, welcome over to Hayden's. Hi.
Go into that really weirdly green patch of that dark green forest.
Oh, that is weird.
There's things to find here. Many hidden things. In fact, all the useful shit ever is here.
Fairy powder.
Snort it. Get high. Jesus, you savage!
You said to snort it.
I didn't mean literally, you sociopath! You just killed 30 children.
Yeah, I probably deserved it. Welcome! Travelers often stop by here to rest. You may stay here as long as you like.
I just want to point out that you said that snorting children would kill them and they deserved it, and your stream went up by 3 followers.
Oh, that's fucking amazing.
Amazing is a statistic that we could use to track that. Yes, I'm not entirely sure it's the one you fucking want, but...
Jesus.
A fairy? She has not returned from Creed's mansion.
They say a fairy lives around here. Do you know her?
Oh?
Go up the stairs.
I'm going.
Okay. Look at those bookshelves.
Creed mansion, only the fairy knows how to get there, but maybe Elric knows because he's a friend of the fairy. I always knew Edward was friends of the fairies.
Secret book! Secret book!
The secret book is what you will use to promote Kazin to sorcerer and make him into an overpowered, destructive force of nature. Save. Don't save yet. You haven't found all the amazing things here. Also, you get to play the Powerball here and get the Vigor Orb, which will allow you to turn a priest into a master monk, whereby they can then kick people in the face so hard their head detaches from their body.
Oh, that's brutal. I like it, I want it.
Auric is out. He went to find the fairy to help a sick dwarf. The forest to the west is very dangerous.
Also, Elric is going to be your first biped archer. Who has his own amusing sort of problems. That being, he looks completely fucking ridiculous.
Is there anything else to find?
Yes, the things that I literally told you you could find.
These are all the useful stuff. I don't know where to find it, though. Let's check in here. Whoop.
In the go to the top left. Top left. Go to the top left. No, the top left of the zone. Not the top left of this building. Exit the building. Go out.
Yeah, I'm going. Mm-hmm.
You notice that there's some weird parallaxing with all the fucking trees here, like you can see under the trees.
Yeah.
Keep on going.
Hey!
Wow, a fucking treasure chest.
Vigor ball!
I'm sorry, a what ball?
Vigor.
Oh.
What did you think I said?
I don't know, Dandy, with your penchant for saying the word, I figured it was the other one. Just creating the game girl style drama here as aggressively as possible.
Vinegar! Yeah, I say vinegar a lot. We use vinegar in cooking a lot.
Anyways, you have to go outside of the houses and then go all the way around. So, like, where you were at, where that ball was, you gotta go even further around. So keep going up.
And this is to go even right, further right. Beyond!
Keep going right. No. God.
Shit!
I swear to God. Holy fucking shit. I'm going to have to break this down for you even more slowly.
I'm fucking it up.
I'm supposed to be the dumb one! Why do you make me seem smart by comparison?
Because as soon as I get my hands on a controller, all my brain cells just stop working.
And why are you trying to stream, you sedative with legs?
Sedative with legs? Because it's entertaining. Come, Mithril. Here's a Mithril, a PETA.
If you're one of the individuals currently in the stream that is entertained by Dandicoot's brain-dead attempts at playing video games, press 1.
Oh.
If you want to see him die within 3 seconds, press 2.
Wait. They pressed 1, 2. Three. Chat doesn't know what they want.
Unfortunately, Jay pressed the button that causes you to blow up an orphanage, so I think we're going to have a problem.
Uh-oh. Welcome to the Fairy Woods special stage. How quickly can you defeat all the hidden monsters? Now set a new record. Best record so far is 5,999 minutes and 59 seconds. How long? Wait a second. Trying to do quick math. No, that's nowhere close to an integer. I guess I'm ready?
Yeah, sure. By the way, every second that ticks up makes a fucking noise, so have fun with that.
Okay.
By the way, get ready to die.
Yeah, I got no idea. I'm just putting people out here.
Yes, Jay, what is it, oh person that chose to blow up the orphanage?
There's people all the way. Ooh, bubbling ooze.
Yeah, check out how much health it has.
I'm sending him out, like, way at the fucking front, because what the hell could go wrong with that? Mist demon. Lesser demon. Oh. I feel like this. Oh my god!
Remember how I said if you pick option two, Dandekoot dies incredibly fast?
Okay, he kind of. That's an adorable, like, demon and stuff, but ow! Ow! Please stop! That he's already dead!
So you may want to cast Egress as fast as humanly possible before everybody that you know and love dies awfully. Just
I know.
Ceases to exist. Cast the Egress spell, lick your wounds, and get ready to leave here and then go left.
Bye-bye! Your desire will be fulfilled. I'm investing on Jaha's exhausted. Yes, that was expensive death.
Well, you know.
It could have been worse. It's a recolored gargoyle. Is it really? I didn't even notice that. Alright. Fairy Woods is a grind spot for players. Yeah, I can see why. But ow. You only had 2 that died compared to just checks notes. 4 that died last time. You know what? That's a good point. Oh, whoops. No, not there. Here. Across here. Weird patch. Okay. Now where is there anything else I need to get here? Or do I just off to the west? Eyes. He's abandoned
extra
me for my incompetence.
Extra virgin olive oil. Daniel Bandicoot going left to leave the area.
Okay. Wait. What?
Leave. Exit. Go down. Go down.
Oh.
Go down.
I was trying to go left because they said to the west.
I believe in your ability to follow instructions.
I can do it. Oh god, here we go. Hold on.
Crumble.
Oh, what you got there? Okay. Alright, soul slower. Oh, that's a new one. The Dark Madame. Madame, m'lady. Let's see. Magic Freeze. Okay. Woo, Conal. Welcome to the chat. It's Stuff Madame. Slow. Soul Slower. Dandy confirmed Neckbeard. Oh my god, could you fucking imagine? I did have a Trilby in college, and I swiftly got rid of it after that stupid shit took off. High Priest. Oh my god.
You need that ball. Kill. Make sure he dies.
Okay. Why would you admit that? I don't know. Why do I admit half the shit I do? I'm on autopilot most of the time when I'm streaming, man.
You need me to take over?
No, I'm probably good. Is it possible for me to give you control through, like, Discord? No, I don't think so. I guess regret is the mother of introspection. Very true. There's a lot of these motherfuckers.
You're correct, there are, and you have to beat the crap out of all of them.
Good thing I know how to do that. The solution is usually just get Peter to the front line and let him just wreck face of literally everyone. Shining Force, welcome to chat, Umarill. I hope I pronounced that correctly. Dude? May, you might want to actually just get back here. Let's see. Okay, Jaha, you're actually doing shit, so... Oh, this is a terrible terrible formation if something has AoE. I assume that stuff will have AoE. Kiwi's still
two.
Only level 16, so
he's gonna Freeze 2 is on the field, so...
Oh, there's a gargoyle! I didn't even see that motherfucker. How dare he? Also, okay, well, that's only six, so Rick's fine. Rick seems to be tanky. Luke is gonna go support him, though.
Bird.
Bird strong. When I get kicked out of heaven because I went up to the tender voice, to the tender of the pearly gates and said, "Hey, Beta," in a Joe Swanson voice. Beta. I can't do that.
Hey, Peter.
See, you can absolutely do it, and it's only mildly concerning. Welcome to the worst show on television. I think it would be the best show on television. I don't know what that bit, like, was saying, like...
Oh my god, have you not seen Bird Up?
I've seen a little bit of it. Like, I saw, like, it's like a bump for Adult Swim, right? Yeah, I saw, like, that, it's... No, I haven't seen the full bit, then.
It's part of the Eric Andre show.
Oh, I see. I was in the ballpark with that.
Were you?
I mean, it aired on Adult Swim. For the love of God, Slade, can you please do more damage so I can bulk you up more? Come on, man. I want a big rat.
You've got one in chat.
I want another big rat.
You already have one.
I am so dumb. I thought he had a ranged attack, but he hasn't.
You already have one.
I love, so here's the, Tim and Eric Awesome Show, great job. I have seen like some skits of theirs and I fucking love all the ones I've seen. Like I've seen like the, what if it was purple? Fucking love that shit. This is now a bird up stream. Do we have Ninja Rat yet? Yeah. I don't know.
He hasn't been promoted yet, no.
Yeah, we haven't done any promotions yet, but I think we might do our first promotion on this stream, depending on how things go. Really, it boils down to...
It boils down to how many friendships you'll lose if you promote incorrectly.
Oh, I mean, I'm terrible at this game. Everyone already knows that. I don't think I can, like, act like I'm good. These sorts of games I just suck at. Oh, hello, Hot Fire. It's going pretty good. How about you, man? Are you surviving? You're doing fine. That's a good point. That's a good point. Kiwi should be able to handle this, right? Yeah. That was a heavy attack. Kiwi's like, fuck you. Oh, there's some wee-woos going on outside. Hold on.
Africanized honeybee Daniel Bandicoot struggling to keep the noise from the background out of the foreground.
Your phrases get more and more colorful every day, which is impressive because they started very colorful.
Sorry, I could make it worse.
No. That's fine.
Do you want colorful? I can make it more colorful.
No. Everything's chill. Everything is fine. Like, I do not ever discount your ability to, like, spice any situation up. You know what? No, because...
LGBTQIA2S+ representative Daniel Bandicoot casting a spell on the wrong enemy. God, it caused me physical pain to list off shit like that.
Say, I've gotten to the point where I don't even know what the fuck my sexuality is. I'm just like, I'm something, man.
Slut, I believe, is the one you're looking
for. Yeah, that's a good one for it. I mean, it's just like, the main thing is like, I like people who are big. I don't really care about, like, gender too much. As long as, like, my sexual preferences are, like, big. But also not a requirement.
You know what you know what I like?
What?
You know what I like?
What do you like? Ah, God, that fucking sound clip. Why is it that exact pitch? Also, you are really, like, quiet for some reason. Your sound clips have been nerfed.
Yes, I nerfed them so that your Twitch chat wouldn't shit their pants and die.
That's a good point, and I appreciate you for doing so.
If you want, I got some louder ones.
I'm terrified.
A really loud one. Hold on.
No! What the hell?
Veteran Twitch streamer Daniel Bandicoot seeing his career flash before his eyes.
I've got Bolt.
Holy shit, that was awesome. I saw your life flash before your eyes.
Oh god.
There are buttons on here that I have that can cause you to have an existential crisis.
You got a lot of very powerful buttons there, man. Like, a lot of them.
Yeah, I do. Like this one.
Ah, oh, God, it's gonna get me copyright claim. No, stop it. That one's probably not, though. That one's probably fine.
I'm feeling a little like a gremlin tonight.
I can see that.
Local Jabberjaw and necrophiliac Danny
Macrophiliac. What? Oh, you misread the shit out of that!
Hold on.
Woo!
Wait a second. Hold on, wait.
I'm gonna die.
I mean, probably from some sort of infection, apparently, based on what I just read.
Oh my god. I'm just gonna eat my burrito.
I don't think that I'm just gonna.
Good night, everybody.
God.
Local musclehead and short-sighted idiot Ice Wolf managing to completely fuck up a readout. Oh, cool, that got clipped. Thanks, guys!
It will forever live in infamy. Don't worry, I've done even worse on stream, and it's been immortalized.
Yeah, that's... I'm posting that on Twitter and outing myself.
Go for it.
Throwing myself to the woods.
Alright, we're gonna just, heal the main character, though. Gonna be doing that.
Everyone on Twitch is like, look at my amazing comeback. Aw, look at this awesome move that I did. Me. Hey, look at me being a fucking idiot.
Dude, being a fucking idiot is what I live for. Like, I cannot wait for the sort of bullshit that's going to happen, like, with some games that I end up playing. Also, I want to start doing more co-op games so that, like, we're doing more stuff together. I'm thinking, like, one day it'll be, like, single-player games, another day it'll be co-op, and then, like, this Saturday's just what the fuck ever. Hey, Peter dodged!
Mm. Oh, by the way, Dandy, guess what?
What?
Thank you for Terminal Montage for all the material that I'm going to be using to supplement my own creativity tonight.
I'm terrified now.
Sorry, I've had so much Diablo 4 on the brain that I just 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 Diablo 4 on the brain that I just... What the fuck is wrong with my audio? Anyways.
He just straight up punched a gargoyle for 20 damage. Holy shit. Oh, God, you got the polio.
No, that was just me.
There's no way that was you. Don't fuck with me like this, man.
Polio!
Oh,
polio!
Polio! Polio! Polio!
Oh, my God.
Not hard to do.
My God, that was you.
Yes, that was me!
That's genuinely impressive. Genuinely impressive in many ways. I'm gonna slap the shit out of this bitch now. Ooh, she got defense.
And honestly, if a giant fish tried to hug me, I'd probably be stunned. I mean, okay,
Metal
first
King
off,
Boo. Oh
first
no.
First off, the first person that's able to create the image that Mizu just described. Hold on, I gotta message Delta. Fucking
20 feet something tall hulking mega werewolf doing the cutest poyo ever while stomping on your house. That's a little cursed. Okay, we're gonna heal from a distance here. Oh, come on. Come on, come on, just go. No, 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 no. Yeah. Tempting. Oh, Art Soul might do it.
Well, I mean, I did draw that picture of Jay once.
It's true. It was a good one, too.
Yeah, I take great pride in the fact that when someone's like, I have this character that's actually me, but, like, you know, nobody draws it because it's not a big, hot furry. And then I draw it, and they're like, I feel seen.
Shining Force 2, let's go. Hey, welcome to the chat, dude. That is a username. I hope you can be happy on this stream, dude. Hope
hey,
we can
you just walked into a fucking trap, my guy. I'm a therapist. You need to talk.
Oh, my gosh. Also, I thought she could do close... Oh... I keep hitting the menu too fucking fast.
You know, Dandy, I'm starting to realize that maybe, just maybe, just maybe, just maybe, just maybe, fucking slow the hell down when you're pressing buttons.
Yeah, probably should. Yay, Jaha got some experience. Yeah, we're gonna put Luke here. Gerhardt's gonna start moving up because anyone can sneeze on that dude and he's gonna die, so I wanna give some experience to someone else. But yeah, we're gonna give it to Slade. I want him to have experience. I just ripped your house off the ground, just say, "Hey, beat it!" so loud it vaporizes it. Hey, Slade's level 20 now, sweet. Are we waiting for level 30 for everyone except Kiwi, by the way?
I mean, that's typically how some people do it. It's entirely up to you. You have refused to grind between sessions, and I'm not going to do it for you.
True. When Kiwi getting the promotion, I'm gonna do it at level 20. I can't be asked with Kiwi. Put Peter over here. I know there's an orc to the south.
I don't know. Wait, what did I say? God damn it. Did I... Azzy, did I say something in, like, Peter's voice or Joe's voice?
You sound more Joe than Peter. Promotion! I can't do the Eggman voice. Or the Robotnik.
Promotion!
There we go. Thank you, Ice. I'm terrible at. I cannot roll my R's to save my life. I can't. Physically impossible. That's such a good mindset to have. I fucking love that.
Anytime someone just pisses me off, I'm like.
God.
Gonna cause Dandy to fucking expire one of these days. Or his career. Who knows? Anybody from Second Life hearing that sixth and starting to sweat and clench their keyboard. Crumple that fucking thing up like a rolled up newspaper.
Snoop. As usual, I say. Yeah, I don't know why. Like, he said that with the emphasis that he did.
Do you imagine if characters in Shining Force were talking about their OCs?
Uh-oh.
Fucking Peter walking up, it's like, "This is my OC, Pyre Sparkbeak. He's got really large pectorals, and he's very attractive. Everybody likes him. He's very well endowed, but he's very polite and doesn't want to hurt anyone's feelings. I'll please commission art of him. I'm a very nice guy." You know, like, I can just imagine it.
Yeah,
Girl just like, "Here's my persona," and it's just him when he's promoted.
But
I got work to do. Slade, like, "This is my..." Slade, like, "This is my human Sona. His name is Edward Darkblade. He's very cool. That's just the main thing. He's just cool, really cool. And everybody wants to be his friend. And I'm not projecting because I'm a lonely rat. Everybody wants to be his friend because I'm not lonely. He's just very cool." And then the main character talking about his OC, and it's just, like, nothing because he doesn't talk.
Sorry, I was thinking really goddamn hard about, like, who I want to kill them. Also, hello, Shoryuken Fox. Welcome to the chat, and thank you for the follow. Bird up.
Is Ice Wolf going to make that the running gag for the rest of the stream?
Yes, and I'm not stopping him. I'm not going to stop him. I will actively encourage him.
You don't want to...
Man, I forgot. I forgot a lot about... Wait, hold on. Okay, Priest is up here, so Slade's
There's
gonna
a reason
heals.
Why people try and keep me occupied so I don't annoy the shit out of them, yet for some fucking reason, people are like, holy shit, Ice Wolf is funny! Am I funny or am I just deranged with a flavor of weird?
A little column A, a little column B, probably.
And a little bit of column by for now.
What? If I had the button set up, I would have absolutely just faded you out there for the bit. I haven't set that button up yet.
Yeah, Hop, I was mashing that button like the first time you tried to find the clitoris. It was a rough time. Anyways.
Oh my god. Smack that heel. I'm working on it!
You think you're gonna smack that ass?
Let's see who's gonna go up.
See, the idea and main goal that I have in a lot of the stuff,
Give him five across the ass.
I'll give you seven across the ass! Don't ask! I lost three of my fingers in Korea!
Oh my god!
That was a reference from back when Game Grumps was funny.
Lost three fingers in Korea. Well, it go to Korea, just try to enter a fucking StarCraft tournament, lose the fingers from trying to hit the keys too much.
Yeah, exactly. I don't think they understood how to end that joke, so they were just kind of floundering when they did it.
See, I sort of got a joke. I said the key parts of it. The setup could have been better. Like, my setup, not yours. But, like...
I'm sorry, I just saw what Newmar wrote! Professional therapist and Twitch co-host Ice Wolf Otten playing audio Russian roulette and threatening the stability of Dandy's stream with the very no-no sound clip that would get him hunted down. Yeah! I got a lot of those, and I use them often when I'm around friends that are understanding and realize I'm just joking because I'm a shock jock asshole.
Oh my god.
What?
Nothing.
What do you want?
I want to welcome a new person to the chat. Hello, Night Night. Welcome.
Did you get your prolapse in a knot? What the fuck's the... Oh, hey, welcome.
That
Sorry
is the worst fucking mental image. What? Tonight is just cursed.
It's gonna get better!
I hope it gets better. I don't want to get worse. Also, Gerhalt's probably gonna die. Oh, nope, he's tanky, but he's gonna have to get back to the healer. The healer's gonna have to get to him. This ain't good.
Local Twitch idiot Daniel Bandicoot projecting his utter hatred for his friend Ice by putting his favorite character in the front lines and letting him die a cursed death.
No, I'm not trying to.
Cast plays too. Cast it. Cast
it. I'm doing it.
Yeah, I'm proud of you. You did so good. Her fucking death isn't in vain now.
Wait, whose?
Don't worry about it.
Okay. Gonna smack
Man,
the
I
shit
like,
out of this priest.
I just like having Hal's don't worry about it in my back pocket like a hand grenade ready to go out at a moment's notice.
Don't worry about it.
That's no, like, you don't understand. It's not just don't worry about us.
Don't worry about it.
I love how there are phrases in the English language that no matter how you say them, people will take them the exact opposite of the literal meaning of those words. Like,
well, playing games with him is great because you'll just be sitting there and he'll be like,
"Don't worry about it. Don't."
Yeah,
don't worry about
I know.
It. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry.
What
worry
was
about
it?
What
I was like, "Wait, what?" And he's like, "Just worry about it." Like, what the fuck? Because, like, we'll be playing Project Zomboid, which, by the way, if you guys want to see some pure, utter, like, fucking nail-biting tension, us playing, we have a big group of people that we've played Project Zomboid with. It's a fucking chaotic nightmare of an experience, and it's great, and I'm always here for it. But when we all play Project Zomboid, there's always that moment where we get it just a little bit over our head. Like, we a case of big dick and forget that we're not our Sonas running around, that we're actually just Joe Schmoes in furry roll-on paint. So, like, you know, maybe some things accidentally become a little instantly fatal, but Hal has this tendency, and I love him to bits, where he'll be, like, off fucking God knows where, doing whatever, his own thing at any time. And then he'll just be like, what?
Just real quick, is healing water a healing item? I know, dumb question. I just wanted to make sure.
I don't know if it... Like, sometimes with these old games, there's mistranslations, and you think something is one thing, but actually it's a critical item that you need for, like, an upgrade or something.
Do you have a healing drop?
No. She's only got healing water.
Go for it.
You'll
learn sooner or later.
What?
Just do it, do it, do it.
Okay. Ice, I am the dumb one. Dandy, after a few minutes, is healing water a healing item?
Listen, there's valid reasons that I ask these questions. I'm sorry. I'm like, I swear there's a reason for this.
Yes. Oh, he doesn't want to get hit by the priest. That would be a bad thing. Can he go up here and hit anyone? No, Kiwi. Kiwi, just go up here, though. Please.
But yeah, so Hal will be fucking just off in La La Land doing his own thing in Zomboid. And we'll be having a good old merry fucking time. And then all of a sudden, we'll hear those words. Ice sitting there being like,
Hal, what you doing?
And then the next thing you hear in the voice call is,
Don't worry about it.
What? What?
Don't worry about it.
Use your words, Hal!
Don't worry about it?
What?
Worry about it.
Wait, what? Actually, no, fucking Keen drew something about this exact thing.
It was so fucking funny. Also, they stayed in that formation. I'm gonna make them regret that.
Sometimes my life becomes a living fucking meme, and it's alright.
I fucking love it.
Yep. 99% stress. Yeah, it do be like that, though.
So say, if you want to send me that picture, I'll throw it up on stream.
Deflated horse penis, also known as a balloon, Daniel Bandicoot banging Ice Wolf for gift art.
What? That's not what I... God damn it, Ice. Deflated horse penis, though. Oh my god. I hate that image. You're filling my brain with a lot of bad things. I can't even visualize this shit. I can't imagine how bad it is for people who can visualize. What even is this stream? What the fuck is this stream tonight?
Undiagnosed Starburst flavor Sluggoo, currently sitting here wondering what the hell all of us are saying.
Is a Slugger, like, chilling out? I saw him reply to... I saw him clip you earlier. I haven't seen him say anything else. You want to visualize something better out of the...
No, but if he's listening, you'll hear it. Hop clipped it.
He sure did. Oh, Luke's dead. That was 24 damage to the face. Those orcs are no joke. Alright, I'm gonna have to gang up on these priests at some point.
Also, Dandy, you may have lowered my volume too much, because from what I'm hearing in these clips, I'm quiet as hell.
Are you?
You listen to one of the clips, numbnuts!
Hey, I'll bump you up a little bit. There you go, you're on level with me again.
And that was Dandekut's last and worst mistake.
I mean, if you're quiet, then I mean, I gotta do something about it, right?
Oh, I but, see. Yeah. That's what gets you to do something about it. Okay, I guess.
What? Alright, man, I need Sarah to be able to heal better, but like, she doesn't have any more items left. Okay.
Someone ought to get ready with that clip.
Furry degenerate Mizu struggling to keep his underwear in contact because one of the people on this Twitch stream speaks a little too quiet to the mic and can't help it that his voice is just a little too deep and a little too horny a little too all of the time.
Stop turning on my Twitch chat! Stop arousing everyone!
Make me.
I can't do that.
Make me! I can't do that! He cries, pleading with his penis that is currently the thing playing the game. Watching like, a Johnson ragdoll around like a Gmod item caught between two boxes.
Just fucking like...
Yeah, if Numar was here, he'd have the fucking sound effect. He could just beam that shit directly to my brain.
Oh my fucking god.
Pop, I'll have you fucking know that's 50% being an asshole and 50% being an asshole.
Stop being horny, I'm trying to draw the shit post. Uh-oh, what shit post? What are you doing? What are you doing over there, Mr. I was gonna say Wolfman, but no, Jay, you're
horny, horny human and otherwise pop you furry artist, Jay, struggling to keep it in his pants while drawing a wholesome shitpost, all while knowing his loins are begging him to do something else.
He says, don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Rick is at one HP.
Yes, Jay. Yes. Oh, yes.
May finally gets to attack something. I feel like she's gonna regret this.
This stream has turned into a creature of my control. It is both organic and inorganic at the same time. Like Velveeta cheese.
Also, yeah, I can't stop him, guys. Like, he's just gonna be like this, so I mean...
The only person that could stop me is married to me, and he knows damn well there's no way to stop this fucking crazy train once it's started.
No, I don't think the crazy train is currently in slow motion into a train wreck. And I fucking love it. Don't remind me of that plastic bag. Yeah, Velveeta is like, there's better options for
my favorite thing. My favorite thing ever is people being like, oh my god, Velveeta is the best for grilled cheese!
No.
Have you ever, like, just taken a fucking... Kraft single and melted the whole thing, wrapped in all over your kitchen range, because that's what Velveeta is.
I don't know why I did this. I really don't. I don't know why I charged a mage for just to piss off an orc. I really don't know why I did that.
I really don't know why. Questionable
choices.
Dandy, I don't know why I did that is basically the... I mean, if you want, I could talk about something fucking wholesome. Otherwise, I mean, I'm just trying to keep it, like, you know, contagious rabies of autism in your chat. If you want me to talk normally about normal shit, I will. Otherwise, I'm going to keep snorting cocaine and projecting it like a mist throughout your Twitch chat.
Oh my god. The words that come out of your mouth.
What do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? Do you want me to go talk about a fucking dancing beaver's asshole, or do you want me to fucking talk about something wholesome? Make choices!
Did you know that vanilla comes from beaver assholes?
Weird, because I thought vanilla came from VANILLA!
No, vanilla is a vanilla flavoring. If you see that it says naturally flavored, it could come from the vanilla bean plant. Or it could come from a beaver's asshole. Well, not exactly the asshole, but a gland that is very close to the asshole. They They excrete this substance that apparently tastes just like it tastes like vanilla, or has the chemical that tastes like vanilla.
You are currently listening to the reason why you should never homeschool your children.
No, this is serious. I'm being 100%. You can look this shit up.
You are currently listening to the reason why you should not be homeschooling your children, because a reasonable person would have beaten this nerd within an inch of his life by now, shoved him in a locker, given him a swirly, and thrown him out of the second story window. And instead, you have to listen to why beaver assholes kind of maybe sort of taste like vanilla bean.
Yeah, so if which there's any beaver furries in
which,
chat...
Which means at some point, somebody got the great idea to lick a beaver's asshole and go,
yeah.
Oh, that's not so bad.
Yeah, so for any beaver furries in chat, if anyone gives you a rim job, don't be surprised if they say, tastes like vanilla.
Yeah, beaver, any beaver butt goo vanilla flavoring is the name of that article. I fucking love it. Oh, that's great.
I mean, the best part, though, is if you grab... Does that mean that, like, someone could take a picture of me, like, just kind of making a holding symbol, and then, like, have a beaver upside down on my head, and then, like, three scoops of ice cream and chocolate sauce on its butthole, just me licking it, being like, it's close enough.
All right, hold on. We got a cutscene, actually.
Do we?
Yeah.
What's wrong, Adler? Is the topic of conversation a little fucked up for you, buddy?
Dandy, Peeta, can you hear that?
I've been doing nothing but hearing that. Wait, hold on. I don't hear anything of substance.
Somebody is crying for help.
It's me! Get me out of this conversation! I need to be stopped!
Hold on, I think I hear something! Here. I hear something!
My... God... Newmar should have never given you the fart soundboard. My god, it's too powerful for you.
I mean, sorry. Look over there!
God.
I'm just having fun flexing the fact that I can change my voice on a fucking dime.
Help me!
Oh, you want to do him? Okay, yeah, go for it.
No, that's honestly, like, he doesn't deserve being done dirty like that, but when you see what he looks like in combat, you're probably gonna realize how good that voice is. An elephant boy, he's stuck in the pond, which is kind of weird for some reason.
I mean, he's an elf, we can just leave him, right?
He must be very tired. Let's pull him out.
Or we can just let nature take its course.
I have wings. I could just lift him out of there.
You know,
it
like
me too. Let's go save him. Come on.
You know, Charles Darwin said that, you know, survival of the fittest. If something's weak, you don't save it. You let it die. Like elves.
Did you come to help me? Oh, thank you. I might have been eaten by monsters if you hadn't come.
My dinner is escaping. Who said that with such preposterously bad acting? That pawn catches my food. Hey, elf boy, good trap, huh? Those who get stuck in the pond are mine. It's my rule.
Then all the missing people were eaten by you?
Like, technically they were in my pond, so I guess, yeah, maybe.
They were in my pond, so I ate them. God, that was a mood.
And this elf is my dinner for tonight, got it? Because he's technically
yeah,
in
sure.
my pod, which by proxy makes him my dinner. You guys bring the ketchup? Ah, well.
Okay.
Wait, that's actually not me shitposting. That's actually a line in the game. Hold on, wait.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. Hold on. No, okay. I'm fine with you eating an elf. I am not okay with you seasoning an elf with ketchup. That's where I draw the fucking line. Yeah, okay, no, even
hold
that's
no,
too
no,
much
no,
for
Dandy,
an elf.
Dandy, 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 Dandy. I'll change the line for you. Did you guys bring any mayonnaise? No? Oh well.
Oh, this motherfucker likes mayonnaise. He needs to die.
I swear to God, all you have to do is bring up mayonnaise or the Wi-Fi password, and this little guy goes fucking nuts. By the way, multiple characters with wings here could be grabbing that elf and pulling him out, but their current priorities? Nah. Let him spin.
Let him suffer. He's an elf. He deserves it. Prissy little fuckers.
Dandy, I'm gonna just fucking ruin you. Hold on.
Okay, listen, I'm sorry. Most elves do not deserve sympathy. Like, the reason I dislike elves in almost any fantasy setting is because they're so pretentious. Every single one of them has just this infuriating aura of just like,
I mean,
I'm better
okay.
than you.
First off, like, unfortunately, okay, so here's the thing, right? Elric is a bro. He just wants to go out and save a dwarf, which is the most un-elf thing ever. But the problem is they did him dirty when they were designing him because that's what he fucking looks like.
All right, hold on. Did you send me something?
Uh-huh.
Oh, here, hold on. I gotta take a small break from the combat to, like, just share this shit on stream. Hold on. First of all, the conversation from earlier, the how, don't worry about it. Here, hold on. Where's the image? Here. Property. Alright, and let me just throw this up on stream real quick.
So,
Yeah, there's
yeah,
that.
It's a, there's that.
It was a birthday, but it was just like, these words have them. Not a problem. Don't worry about. Ice is not amused.
All that, right, by the way, that literally is from us playing Project Zomboid.
Yeah. Alright, and let me get this picture of this pretty little elf boy up on stream.
It's, they did him dirty. In the ROM there, hack I'm currently playing, they actually completely fixed his sprite and made him look somewhat respectable.
See, the only elf that I kind of vibe with is Link. Like, he's the only one. No,
okay.
Actually, there are a couple other elves.
Right,
I just can't remember.
Dandy, here's the thing. Look at how he's... Okay, what does it look like he's wearing? It looks like he's wearing ripped-up clothes.
Yeah, like, they look like...
It looks like he's
like
wearing
battered.
Ripped-up clothes,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So here's the problem. Well, first off, anatomically, as an artist, the wrist to glove and hand ratio on that is Yahweh hands times 30.
Yahweh hands. I forgot that was a thing. It has been so long since I've heard someone call him that.
But the problem is, the sprites they made for him didn't make it look like he had ripped up clothes. They make it look like his clothes are made out of flowers.
Oh, that's so much better.
No, it makes it look like he has flower petals for the top of his boots, and that the shit around his neck is a flower, like a leaf, and then it makes it look like he's got a fucking leaf around his waist. Like, the art team got a little drunk and fucked up.
Damn, everything is, like, just out of range. This is the most frustrating layout I've ever had.
Why don't you just walk around?
I'm trying.
Do or do not. There is no try.
It means as I argue that the Zoras are the elf of Hyrule. No, Hylians,
no,
absolutely.
No,
Hylians are.
Awesome.
Yeah, Hylians are like the royal family and Link. And the royal family are a bunch of assholes. And I have so many things I could say about the royal family and why they're assholes across history. Like, oh my god. Don't even get me started on the theories of Ocarina of Time and stuff. I won't shut up.
What's different from normal?
The Hyruleans are the common people, not the royal family. There's a difference between the Hyruleans and the Hylians. Did you know that? The Hylians are specifically of royal blood and Link for some reason. The Hyruleans are the common people, though. Like you said, the way you can tell if someone is a Hylian is whether or not their ears are pointed. If you notice, in... Man, you don't let me have anything, do you?
You know the soundboard panel I'm on? I have another button I can press!
I know. I understand. I'll behave. Oh my god. Oh, I'm poison! Oh, these things poison! Oh, really? Okay! Ah! Filthy birds. These aren't
Wait,
the sexy
why the
kind.
Fuck, why the fuck do you want to yell at me? I was the one shutting up Dandy and defending your fucking point, Miza, you dense sack of whale shit.
Whoa, don't insult the chat. That's mean.
I was stating a fact.
You are like at like an 11 today, mister.
Yeah?
Out of six.
Yeah, well, it's because something wholesome happened to me today, so shut the fuck up and let me enjoy it.
I enjoy that.
I am!
Cut.
So I got an aunt who kicks ass. She's awesome. And I literally just talked to her on the phone for like 2.5 hours, basically doing a therapy session for her. Then we did a tarot reading for the fuck of it. And my cousin came in, who was like my best friend till I was, my only friend till I was 15. And still continues to be one of my best friends. And we talked for a fucking other hour. So I basically spent the entire afternoon on the phone instead of working, but it was a pretty good spending of time, I think.
Yeah, reconnecting with family is always nice. Especially family is actually cool.
It's not, I wasn't a reconnect, it's just I have really, like, a really good relationship with my aunt, period.
Yeah, she's really fucking like, cool.
She is, because both she and I are very much aware that my mother is a sack of whale garbage. My mother is like Schrodinger's decency, except, you know, there's none of it.
I'm gonna stab a fucking, mage now.
If any of you guys ever have, like, trouble with family or like, you know, been abused by your parents, contact me directly. I will help you out therapy-wise. I've been abused by my parents my whole life. I'm here for you.
Ice is absolute sweetheart in multiple ways. I love how we went from chaos and horrible stuff just immediately to like just aw, wholesome.
Yeah, I told you the second I fucking said that it ruined your stream. Now everybody's all happy and thinking wholesome shit instead of being like, wow, Ice was some sort of weird gremlin today.
I mean, we all go gremlin mode sometimes. It's just a thing.
It was just because I was really happy that I was fed. That's what happens when Azzy puts food in my mouth.
We shout each other, but I do love you guys. Aw, we love you too, Mizu. Love all you guys.
You should see what happens when he puts dick in my mouth. No, not the fucking grapefruit job! Usually
you've never
not
used a grapefruit technique?
Nah, usually when he stuffs his dick in my mouth, there ain't enough room for me to make sound like that.
Oh, damn.
It's like an act of violence against the Twitch chat, I apologize. Somewhat, not really.
These orcs look like the moblins from Ocarina of Time. The grapefruit, man, I would say look it up on YouTube, but at the same time,
it definitely
doesn't exist on YouTube anymore. They took it down.
You have to look it up on the normal internet, which is quickly becoming impossible to use for some reason.
Wait, hold up, let me make this work. No, wait, please, Numar, don't. No, wait.
Doing it.
Please stop, no. I was hoping that would get the harpy down to 1 so Kiwi could finish it off, but eh. Uh-oh.
No, Numar, you can't. No, you can't give me power like that, man.
What did he do? What did he give you?
He gave me the grapefruit job sound effect. I must be responsible and not use it.
No, don't, no.
Oh, it's so tempting.
No, please, I beg you.
Oh my god, it's like being given a loaded gun in a public... You know what, I'm not gonna do that one. That'll probably get you canceled too.
I don't know what you were gonna say, but I'm glad that you stopped.
I'm feeling a little chaotic right now.
I can tell! I'm scared. Jay, you're not the one on stream with him!
Roar. Oh yeah, I can turn that shit from scary gremlin to something else real fucking quick, and don't you ever forget it.
God.
That's a decent title. You can workshop better ones.
Hey, Conal! Oh, that wasn't Conal's subscribe. Numar gave the gift sub! Fucking thank you.
My god, Numar, you're crazy. Save it.
Numar just nutty. Just yeeting so much money. Alright. I'm trying to do damage to these orcs, and it is proving to be very difficult. Okay, this harpy's at least going down, so I can start moving others up. Perfectly balanced between order and chaos. The chaos of the grapefruit technique for one sub. Oh, Conal, Numar just gifted you a sub, and I thought you would sub, but, like, I mean, I guess technically you're sub now, but Numar is the one who paid it. I don't know, words.
Yeah. But, no, I, for those of you who don't know Conal, he's like a little brother to me. He's a wonderful guy. And by little brother, I mean, like, he's, like, the literal, like, little, like...
He and I are short stack buddies. Wait. No. Kiwi might. Yeah, Kiwi's probably gonna be healing. Like. Oh boy, Chester needs healing! Chester can run back. Aw, Conal, thank you for the follow! Y'all are fucking wonderful. I love you guys.
We're literally doing it for you, so.
I'm gonna do it for you!
Oh, no, I'm not gonna.
Kiwi is... Can we just go in this corner real quick? May, fire over his shoulder. I didn't know you still counted short side heal height to me today. Hey! Just because you're freakishly tall, it doesn't mean I'm not swole. Bring Jaha over here. Yeah, I just want to get this orc taken care of, because they're scary.
Now you pick the right character to slap him in the gooch with.
Yeah. Who is Slade gonna get the last hit? Hey! Alright, Gerhalt's coming out. Rick. I don't know if I. Rick's just gonna slap the arrow launcher.
Slap.
Wow. Okay, so that harpy's coming down. I need to be aware of that. Chester is
Daniel
gonna just...
Bandicoot training his spatial awareness with expert skill today. Yeah, that was a compliment. Now you don't know which way they're coming.
Nah, I got this. Oh! Oh, bye, Kazen. Was everyone hoping for tomorrow's Nintendo Direct? I don't know, I'm hoping that they announce new fighters for Smash Bros. Somehow, miraculously, and Phoenix Wright finally gets his place in it. That's not gonna happen.
Very, very specific desires for me today.
Hey, Shiro, thanks for the follow. Listen, I wanted Phoenix Wright in Smash Bros. For so fucking long, man.
Well, did you call them and ask to put him in?
No, my uncle said he couldn't get a meeting with them. Miyamoto-san is booked pretty heavily.
Oh, that's rough.
Yeah. I mean, I got an uncle that works there. Doesn't mean he has connections.
God, remember how that was a thing?
Yes. Remember when people were talking about Pokemon Purple back in grade school?
They were like, oh, you'll be able to, like, fuse Pokemon together and stuff, and it's gonna be so cool. I'm like, where did you hear that?
Oh, my dad works at Nintendo.
And I fucking believed it, because I was that kid who would believe anything. New DK, New Sapphire, or New Star Fox? Yo, New Star Fox would be great. Like, I really, really want more Star Fox.
I want them to stop ruining it.
They tried rebooting it with Zero, and it did not.
Yeah, they tried, alright.
They tried. But hey, they at least did, like, release, like, Star Fox 2 after how many years? Are they gonna take down Peter? No, Peter's a god. Of course not.
Oh, he's nutty! Maybe, like, Nintendo's sitting there feeling like they've got a loaded gun to their head.
What do you mean?
Well, because, like, they've got Star Fox, right? But they also know furries exist, so...
True. They're, like, a little conflicted.
What do I do, Lord?
I'd be amazed if they announced Tears of Kingdom DLC already. I mean, it's, like, their biggest fucking money printer right now, so, I mean, possible.
Hmm.
What about Crash Bandicoot Purple and Spyro Orange on the Game Boy Color? What? I never heard of that one, but man, I can see people like trying to make something up like that.
I can see someone buying that, yeah.
Well, I'm just gonna stab a priest real quick. GBA. Yeah, I didn't hear about that stuff. Wait, Matt, were they real? What? I don't think they were real. You guys are fucking with me.
Daniel Bandicoot's Twitch chat struggling to gaslight him at the start of this beautiful week.
Those were actual game. No. No, they weren't. Hey, welcome to the chat, Shiro. Probably Pikmin 4 and Splatoon 3 DLC stuff. Yeah, I'm excited to hear about Pikmin 4. I haven't really played much of Pikmin games. Like, the only one I played is 1. But, you know, I still love hearing about it because it's like... I did it again, Ice. Did you see how I did it again?
Mm-hmm. Yup.
I'm not happy with myself right now.
Yup.
Ooh. Kiwi can slap the shit out of that harpy. Ooh, that's gonna be uh-oh.
Sigh.
Okay, hold on. He's gonna go over, like, I guess here. Dead Slade. I'm a genius. Oh no! That's how it feels! That's really how it feels. Oh my god. Oh no! Jaha's poison. If Jaha doesn't heal, then he's just dead.
That's yeah, but awesome. You don't really give a shit about him anyways, so.
I kinda gave a shit ever since he got an actual axe.
Oh.
Rick's probably gonna die, but I need to lay damage down. 4 damage, yeah, that's fucking worth it, sure. I'm sorry! Are you attacking my healer? Oh, that's not good. This is extremely not good. Everything that's happening is just... These orcs must be weak to something. Yeah, I know! They must be weak to something. I wish I knew. Oh, Peter's dead. I might lose this match. Hold on.
Wild how even though they're level 24, you're still getting ganked and spanked.
I know. Egress? No, I can do this. I can do this. I need to get Kiwi that level at least. Like, Kiwi can hit. I literally can't heal any of the people that need it the most. There we go, just heal myself. Hey, you got a level off that. You're healing, you're supposed- Listen! Alright, Kiwi. Do it!
Do it! Get your experience! Yay! Yes! Yes! More for Kiwi! You only lose experience earned so far when you grass fight. No, no you don't. But I'm just a stubborn motherfucker. Do I use an antidote to live one more turn only to get bitch slapped by this orc, or do I just... I'm just gonna lay it down. I'm just gonna attack.
Just whack him. You need the DPS. Yeah. Jaha can come back. He's short and fat.
Oh! Another target for Kiwi! Yes!
Oh my god, he died in vain.
Okay, fuck this harpy.
Daniel Bandicoot actually taking his fucking team seriously for a change.
Yeah, boy! Also, hello, Darius. Welcome to the chat.
Famous well-endowed snow leopard Darius showing up in chat for the first time.
Here, we're gonna block this thing from getting anywhere down, and so its only option is go east.
Is it creepy when I know? Is it creepy when I like identify people based on their name and call them out the second they walk in? That feels kind of fucked.
Eh. I mean, in this community, the world's a small place.
Yeah, I figured it was like, oh, I feel seen, you know.
Does this game have a bun character? I'm not sure.
Not this one, no.
Oh, yeah, there goes Rick. I'm gonna have to, this is gonna be an expensive heal, but it's fine. I can't believe I'm going through all this for an elf.
Do you want me to make you feel better?
Eh.
You can put that elf in a tank.
Okay, that does make me feel a little bit better. That. Yeah. Alright, I'm fine with just, you know, just some, there's some poison happening, but that's fine. I'll take care of that. Oh! Come on! Come on!
Oh,
that should have been. Mm. Alright, well this, at least, you know, this is absolutely going to hit.
Mm.
Ding!
Is it? Yeah, there you go.
Every turn you don't egress just makes it more expensive. You know, that's a good point, but now there's only two enemies left. So I'm just gonna keep going. Alright, come on, Geralt.
Daniel Bang. Oh, well, yeah, of course I can finish.
There we go. God damn it, Numa. Oh! Are you?
Oh my god.
Are you? I was at like almost 40 health. What? Hold on. No. No, wait. Oh, come on. That was literally the last one. The game forced me to egress. Holy shit! Oh my god, at least I keep the experience, but oh my god.
And there goes half your money. Remember how your Twitch chat was saying you know what, Twitch chat, all 34 of you wonderful, amazing, strong-willed people, could you please turn on him for like a good 20 to 30 minutes?
No.
Just really beat the shit out of him. Like, fucking just...
No. I totally had it! I had it under control!
God, yeah, that just... Mm. Well, Jay, everybody in Twitch chat kept saying Dandy should egress because he was having a hard time. And then Dandy
being a strong, tough, terrific boy with no flaws whatsoever.
Ain't shit on the last enemy. That guy killed his main character, took half of his money, and sent him back to town. Don't forget to buy healing items now that you're fucked up.
Let me just trip. Yeah, we're gonna have to stock up on healing items and do some inventory shuffling.
By the way, Dandy, I'm gonna teach you a little cool thing now. Leave town. Yeah. Leave town. This'll make it hurt a little less. Hit A. Sorry, hit C.
What?
So this is the secret functionality of the caravan. This is your headquarters. So you see that depot thing?
Oh, depot! Deposit.
Deposit.
Yes. 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 Get rid of this. Yes. Yes.
Now remember, nothing can be used from inside there. So if you have a class promotion item for a character, it needs to be taken out of the thing.
Okay. Drystone, is that a thing?
The Drystone is going to be used later on in the game to access a secret area where that mithril is used. So just hold on to it.
Okay, we're gonna put that in the storehouse. Or actually, should I carry it with me?
No.
Okay. Oh my god. Okay, so we can just store all this shit. Fairy powder? What is fairy powder?
Fairy powder. I think fairy powder is like the ultra status cure.
Okay, we'll keep that with me. Secret book?
That turns a sorcerer. Turns a mage into a sorcerer.
Alright, restore
for
that.
Streamer and writhing mass of scratched up bloody corpse of the late Dandy S. Bandicoot didn't listen to his chat to egress, and RNGesus decided to stop by for a visit and slap his shit by having a harpy double kick his skull in the back of his head.
My god. Silver tank, do I deposit that?
Yes, that would turn somebody into. That will turn someone into a brass gunner if they're an archer.
Angel wing?
That just egresses you.
Vigor Ball.
Turns your character from a priest to a master monk.
Okay, Vigor Ball in the storehouse. Bright Honey? I wonder what that does.
I'll look it up.
Okay. In the meantime, more Mithril.
Bright Honey increases a character's maximum MP.
Okay, so I'm going to want to use that on someone. We'll see that. Running Pimento, we don't want to use until after someone's promoted, but I'm going to keep that with me. Professional Twitch streamer and stubborn ass, Dandy S2, instantly throws away hours of training for God knows what reason. Hey, I still keep the experience. That's the cool thing about this game. I do keep the experience.
Nothing is lost. It just keeps getting stronger. It's just, it hurts emotionally.
Yeah, like my pride is like in shambles right now. I'm not going to be the same sort of man after all this. Join, urge, how do I leave?
Just B.
Yay, here we go. Okay, so item shop? Is this? I meant ice is raining on you. Oh. Hurts kind of. See, I still got 6,000 gold. It's all fine. Hey, Copper Red, thanks for the follow. Leather glove. Do I need that? Flail? Oh, wait, no, these are the promotion items. That's right. Let's see.
Oh, hold on one second. I just want to wish Jake a happy birthday, man. You've really been knocking it out of the park lately, and we all believe in you. Keep on going, man.
Aw.
That was to, like, nobody I know right now, but at some point, if someone, like, looks at the VOD and their name is Jake and they're having a birthday, it's really, really gonna fuck them up.
God damn it.
Let's see. What?
Chat sent me like happy birthday. Oh. Oh, wait, sorry, I did that once to somebody. Like, I wished a whole room of people happy birthday, but I didn't say who. I was like, oh, hey, happy birthday, dude. And then I literally heard, aw, thanks. And I was like, huh, might want to try that more often.
Okay. I'm trying to find the shop. I'm really trying.
Wouldn't that be funny if, like, instead of drive safely, if my catchphrase was happy birthday and just made it even more chaotic? Yeah, we already hit up the shopkeeper by the door, I believe.
We did, but they were... those are items for, like,
Newmar, it technically, yeah, tomorrow did. Could be someone's actual birthday. I'm sure it's somebody's birthday right now. If you want to wish them their happy birthday, just fucking send the video to them, and you just wish them happy birthday.
Here it is.
It literally just transformed people's life into a better thing, just because I'm fucking weird. Right.
Okay, so... we're gonna give everyone a healing drop because I can afford it and I really don't care. We're gonna make sure everyone has a healing drop. Sarah actually is gonna have two healing drops. Jaha, Chester, and Rick can equip those weapons. After I finish buying these items, I'll check their equipment and we can see if they already have them or not. Actually, so Jaha has the battle axe and Chester has the power spear.
Okay.
He's already got that. Slade, you're gonna... also, I'm gonna have to... actually, let me use that bright honey real quick. Oops, no. Stop. Ember. I wanna use the... item. Hey, Lord Power! Thank you for the follow! Okay, so we're gonna use... bright honey. Who should I use it on, though?
Kazen, because, either Kazen or Sarah, probably Kazen, because as a sorcerer, his spells take up just a biblical shit ton of MP.
Wait. Oh, no.
What did you do?
You're not gonna like it.
What'd you do?
I accidentally used the bright honey on someone who didn't have MP because I was trying to figure out how to view who has MP, and then it used the item, and so we just don't get that now.
Who was it that used it on?
I think I tried using it on Jaha. And it just right. Took it! It just took it from me!
Press right on the D-pad.
It just took it from me, Ice, because I was trying to activate the menu that shows me the MP, and now I don't have it.
Twitch chat, I'm gonna need you to really amp up that bullying. Guys, do you guys want VTubers? Should we, like, do actual full 3D VTubers so you can fucking throw shit at him when he does this stuff? Because it really feels like he would have been fuck-punted into oblivion for that. Fucking tornadoes, bananas, dumpsters, doesn't matter, throw a computer monitor. I can't fucking believe it. Call your fucking ex. I want your ex in here now. Not so he can see that, but so he can strangle the life out of you.
Hold on, I'm going to sell my stem screaming. One second. Hold on.
Oh my god, the idiot's actually doing it.
Hold on, I'm just going to tell him. Because he's gonna need to know this. He's gonna find
Mizu, he used a permanent stat boosting item to raise MP
on a character that didn't have MP, and it just didn't do anything, and he wasted it.
There we go. Babe, can you come flap my dick live on stream? Dude, he'd do so much worse than that. His son is a cat. He can say such mean things. I love
him,
though.
Just because you're a cat doesn't give you, like, a license to be a cunt, like...
No, like... Dude, no, I'm saying, like, cats... a lot of the cats that I've met can be savage. And not, like... and I'm not like, oh, they're total jerks and assholes or, like, anything like that. It's just, like, man... They have some bite to their words sometimes. I love all my friends, obviously. But, like, whew.
Professional Twitch streamer Nicholas Nocturne, capable of eviscerating somebody because both he and Graffy are cats.
See, like, they are, like, the very rare cat furries I've met where they're just, like, chill all the time. They're Rileys. Like... They are like that. Anomalies.
You don't know that. Nick could actually have some real demon seed in him. I mean
he is
phrasing.
I'm gonna need to rewatch the stream to clip that, cause that is taking longer than fucking minute for a clip I want to call taking honey from a bandy. God damn it.
I'm still stunned at just the fucking doings that just transpired. I really am.
Sometimes I really fuck up, man. Eon, thank you for the follow.
I know, our friendship is evidence.
Wow. No. I love our friendship. That's not a fuck up. How dare you?
Speak for yourself.
Whoa. Listen, I know I'm a lot to put up with.
Sometimes, yeah.
Alright, I think everyone is now all stocked up. The bright honey's gone.
Well, at least your inventory's lighter. Positive spin on that.
Yeah.
Brain dead fucking moron.
Alright. Damn, you fuck up like a program. Hey, fail fast!
Oh yeah, you did just have a programmer moment, didn't you?
Sometimes I do things without fully thinking through, and
my favorite thing about programmers is that you guys have this really interesting fucking reaction to success that cracks me up every time I see it.
Fear, uncertainty,
egress, just egress from.
I'm going to. That's what I'm.
No, like sometimes when you fuck up, it's funny as hell, and sometimes it's like. When you succeed, you treat it like a fuck-up.
Well, it's like... If you succeed on the first time, it's a little terrifying because you're like, something's gonna break.
Yeah, it's like,
something
has to
break.
It's like, we did it! Why is this working?
Why is this working first try?
Why is this working?
There has to be something wrong here.
It shouldn't be working. What is going on here? This isn't... Did I fuck up? No, it's working. Yeah, I know. On the first try. No, it is functional. What do you mean? No, I have no idea how. Yep, hey, guess what? Time to egress again.
Yeah.
Look at you. This isn't on you, Dandy. This is the game. Don't feel bad. Trust me, there will be plenty of time for you to feel bad.
That's why I don't want to work as a programmer, just the IT guy. You know what? That's fair. I fucking love being a programmer, though. Although, I have discovered something, and I know some people may feel iffy about it. However, I have realized AI is really good when you don't have anyone else to be your debugging partner.
Yeah, I can see it.
Just for the love of God! Okay, if I get back and I just have to do that one fight over again, then so be it.
Just go into the church, dude. Like, go into the elven tree church thingy. Walk up to the guys.
What do you mean?
You know, like, that little one tile of whatever. Instead of, like, walking past it, just walk into it. You know where you got the vigor ball and stuff? If you walk in there and talk to that priest...
and save.
Oh, the next time, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay.
In case it sparks the battle again, you could just egress in there.
Gotcha. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Who's got a good Karen story? Anybody got a good Karen story?
I used to work at Starbucks. Oh, it's not a Karen, but it is a... What is the fucking male equivalent of a Karen? What do people agree? A Ken? Yeah, I got a Ken story. I worked at Starbucks for like 3 years. And also I'm trying to find the fucking church here. That's right, up here. Kevin. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so I was working at Starbucks. I was on drive-through duty. So basically, I would take orders, and sometimes I would also make the drinks while in drive-through, and you know, exchange people's money and all that stuff. Some days were rougher than others. Well, there was one time that I was just on drive-through, and dude came through. He ordered some sort of drink and stuff, but that's not what I remember about him. What I remember is that I was sitting there in the drive-through. Oh, well, at the drive-thru window on my headset, I was like, hey, welcome to Starbucks. What can we get for you today? And he said his drink, and he was like, oh, by the way, do you guys have any of those, like, chocolate-covered espresso beans? And I was like, let me check for you. So I went and checked. And I was like... And I didn't see any. You know, we didn't really carry... you know, some of the extraneous items because we were a pretty small store. So I was just like, I'm sorry, sir. Doesn't look like we have any right now, but we're going to be getting like a truck later today. Might have some on them. And he was like, you know what? Cancel my order. I'm making a stand today. I'm like, oh my God. I am 30 minutes from being off. Why am I dealing with this dude? And
don't
he was like,
up there.
Like up here?
Yeah, don't put him up there.
Okay.
Don't be stupid.
And he was like, I'm so sick and tired of you people not having my chocolate covered espresso beans. You guys advertised on your board out here. Spoiler alert, we didn't. I don't know what the fuck he was talking about.
Oh God. My favorite part is that he said my.
Yeah. And he was like, it's false advertising, and I'm so sick of it. And here, what did he say next? He just said, you know, the coffee here isn't even that good. You guys always screw it up anyways. I don't know why I come here. I'm like, oh my God, is this really the hill you're gonna die on, dude? And then he was like, I'm gonna be writing a review of you guys on Yelp. Oh no, it wasn't Yelp, it was fucking TripAdvisor. TripAdvisor, guys! He was gonna write us a bad review on TripAdvisor.
Whoa.
And... I don't know why I did that. And...
Whoa, settle down, Satan. Like...
And he was like, you know what? Actually, I want to speak to your manager. I'm going to let them know that you guys aren't serving me the way that I deserve to be served. I'm like... And I just look over at my shift supervisor, who has been listening very intently to this conversation the whole time. And the moment, literally the nanosecond he said that he wanted to talk to a manager, she clicked on the headset and was just like, hi, I'm sorry, the manager isn't here right now, but I am the shift on duty. How can I help you? And he just immediately sped the fuck off because at that point he realized, oh shit, she had been listening to everything he had been saying. And I just looked at her and I was like, and then I had to walk over.
And that was the day my shift manager and I became close friends.
So I wish. But then here's the epilogue to that story. Literally, the next customer was asked for some extraneous item. And so I checked under the registers, because that's usually where we kept the box of other stuff that, you know, isn't typically bought. And I just saw, buried in the very, very back, oh look, chocolate-covered espresso beans, we did have some. If he had been patient and waited in line, I literally would have found them for the next customer. and or found them because of the next customer, and I would have been able to offer them to him at the window. But instead, he threw a hissy fit and didn't get his beans or his coffee that day.
Oh well, Karen.
It was so fun. God, I am really not thinking.
I didn't want to say anything. You were having a good story.
Yeah, I now I need to actually focus. Oh my god, Jaha, just stay back here. Also, what genius at Starbucks decided to put olive oil in coffee? You know, I have no idea what those people think of. Corporate was always just dumb as hell when I worked there. But I can tell ya, the only thing it's missing is some prune juice and be the strongest laxative in the entire world. The olive oil coffee that gives instant diarrhea. Yeah, no. If you combine olive oil, a natural laxative, with coffee, a natural laxative, you're gonna be shitting. Like, just don't do it. Also, charged lemonade that can kill you. Hold on, what? That one's new to me. I'm gonna need some context for that one.
What?
Charged lemonade that can kill you. I haven't heard of this one. Power word shit. Daily safe limit of caffeine in every cup. Oh yeah, like Starbucks has like insane amounts of caffeine, insane amounts of sugar. By the way, if you guys want a good reason to stop drinking Starbucks, go look up the nutritional facts of how much sugar is in a Frappuccino. Just do it. Specifically, look up the sugar content of a cotton candy Frappuccino. It's a cream-based Frappuccino, so it doesn't have coffee in it, but,
Oh.
Did you look it up?
Oh. It's on the secret menu.
The cotton candy is not on the secret menu. There's no It was on the official menu when I was there working there. Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, how much ice? How much? In a grande, which is 16 ounces. That is the medium.
Still looking.
Okay. Okay, Rick, just get back here to the priest. You're gonna need the heals.
This looks garish and awful. It's hot pink.
Yeah, so the cotton candy frappuccino is vanilla bean and raspberry combined.
It's not cotton candy then. That's false advertising.
That's what people called it. It was a secret menu item that became an official item because enough people bought it. It's delicious. I love it. However, the amount of sugar in that single drink could kill the average man. There was one time on a dare, it was a really slow time somewhere around the holidays. Slow time around the holidays was just
55
rarity.
Grams of sugar.
In 16 ounces, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's a lot. That's more than a soda, man.
Well, I think I speak for everyone when I say ick.
Oh, it's so delicious, though. I'm a sugar fan,
is
though.
Is it?
There was...
Yeah,
there was
no, you seriously, like, sat there, turned your nose up at $200 of sushi, and then immediately started to harf down Skittles. What the fuck
is you're not gonna
this?
Let me live that down, are you?
Honestly, I wasn't planning on it, no.
It's not one, so I can't let Kiwi hit. Say, there was one time around the holidays, though. We had all of our holiday drinks, you know, like gingerbread, peppermint mocha, what else do we have? I forget what else there was around the holidays.
Dumpster shark, I think that was that one flavor.
No, that was more of a springtime drink, actually.
The big squidge.
Big squidge. That was more of a summer thing. Actually, no. That was a partnership with Nintendo for advertising Splatoon.
What about Boysenberry Moose Knuckle?
Boysenberry Moose Knuckle?
I'm just fucking, like, having too much fun making up fake Starbucks drink names.
And me struggling to continue the joke every time.
Yeah. Oh, it's great watching you flail. It's fun.
Anyways, the thing that I did on a dare, I need to get this out because this is actually awful. So it was like gingerbread, peppermint, mocha,
pepperoni,
fucking caramel brulee. No, it was caramel brulee. At Starbucks, it's caramel brulee. And it's just every holiday flavor. Like, if you've ever been to Starbucks and you know the holiday flavors, you know the same ones they bring out every year. Now imagine someone takes all of those flavors at, like, one pump of every single flavor, okay? Every single one. Puts it in a cup, and then puts a shot of espresso in there and tells someone to drink it.
Did they get fired?
No. We're allowed free drinks on the clock. And so someone made that and said, hey, Dandy, drink this. And I asked what it was. And they told me. And I was like, oh, this is gonna be good. And I just shot it back. And I'm like, that certainly tastes like Christmas. It was an experience. Let me tell you that.
Yeah, enough experience to level down.
Oh, God.
Yes, my child?
I don't know. I'm just reminiscing about some of those days. I'm trying to remember other, like, ridiculous stories I had from back then. Because, like, with my current job, there's not many, like, ridiculous stories that are, like, relatable, really.
My favorite part is sometimes when I open my mouth and Twitch chat immediately starts to vomit in their mouth.
Dandy didn't know a drink could cause brain damage, explains so much. Hey, I had the brain damage far before that.
I had a question for me about what goes through my head.
Yeah.
So it's about kind of like this.
What about a boy cat?
God. Fucking don't hug me, I'm scared. I think there were a few of those I didn't see, I think.
My favorite part about don't hug me, I'm scared is how everybody, anytime one of those comes out, dive bombs on Nick and just won't shut the fuck up about trying to get him to do it. Meanwhile, Nick's just like,
guys, I'm trying to do my own thing. I know I made that one video once, but I'm more than just the dumb. Oh, God. Oh, God, please stop.
Like, it's you can see the life leave all four of his eyes.
Poor guy.
He's a sweetheart.
He really is.
Also, for those of you that are really into the idea of having guys with sexy fucking voices narrate an audiobook to you.
Oh, yeah, plug the fuck out of his audiobook.
Yeah. To the 30-something people that are going to see this at some point in their fucking lives.
Dan, you forgot to put NSFW18+ on the stream name again. I'll put it on the stream name because it's already a setting. And say, if you're not 18, you can't watch this stream as far as I know, so...
God damn it.
So if anyone isn't 18, please kindly leave. I like everyone, I like the support, but also, if you're not 18, you're not supposed to be here. Forgot the hydrate button. I don't need to be reminded to hydrate. I've been sipping this whole time. In fact, I'm gonna take a sippy right now.
Ugh. Why did it sound like that?
I sipped it down the wrong pipe. Oh God.
You okay?
Bye.
Sounds like you might not be fine, actually.
I'm mostly fine.
Is it? Are you?
Sounds like you might be having a little bit of a problem.
I'm fine.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Stab the shit out of that priest. I'm good now.
Nick, did you not link your fucking ebook? Where the fuck is it? Damn it, Nick. You nocturnal animal that is clearly unavailable for me to communicate with right now because you went to bed at, like, noon.
Yeah, I swear to God. What? How's that, hello, Blue Dirk? Welcome. Listen, I am an absolute mess. You guys should know this by now. I don't know why you guys don't. You guys have been following me and friends with me long enough. Daniel has been nearly having a stroke midstream. I'm gonna try sipping again.
He's gonna try sipping again, folks.
I have succeeded in the sip.
You did it. You got your slizzerup done.
Yep.
I cannot find the fucking link for. Maybe it hasn't been officially published yet.
Yeah, I know. Didn't he say something about it on Twitter, though?
He did, but he didn't post anything about it, so I don't think it's.
Okay. He might have finished it, it just hasn't gone up on official services yet. Okay.
Someone on fucking Twitter was like, it must be wild knowing you, and I just replied, it's an experience.
Finally, Kiwi gets to go and slap this thing. Yes, more experience for Kiwi. I'm gonna make Kiwi a kaiju. And if you, are you eating though? I deep-throated two burritos earlier, but I don't think anyone wants to hear that.
The eponymous burrito, air quotes.
Yeah, I was just double fisted a couple of burritos. It was great. And this whole, like, healer is on the other side of the map.
I just want to really point out to chat that he's basically spent this entire 2 hours trying to do this one fight.
No, it's fine.
Is it? Because you almost just fucking died again.
Fine. I'm gonna win.
You're gonna get to a point where your characters can't equip weapons anymore, by the way.
Why is that?
Because your weapons eventually get class locked, as in only promoted characters can use them.
Oh. I mean, we're gonna be promoting, like, soon-ish. Egress now. No, I'm fine this time. See, look, all I gotta do is kill that harpy, and then just keep my main character just surrounded like they currently are. Also, we're gonna do this little thingamabob. We're actually gonna heal. Use our healing items. Healer doesn't have to be near the allies if they have healing items of their own, right?
Correct.
One sec, I need to. Okay, that one's gonna be Kiwi's gonna smack. Luke, I'm gonna just bring you back, man. Hello, T-Rex. Welcome to the chat. Professional ding dong Dandy Esku doesn't learn from history. You know what? That's fair to say.
Expert at ding dong ditch, Daniel R. Bandicoot, figuring out a little too late what happens when you fuck around and find out.
That's fine. We're fine. I don't know why you're, like, so scared. Like,
fucked up, insecure, neurotic, and emotional.
We're just gonna...
Blasted heart palpitation, Daniel Bandicoot.
That's heart palpitation. He's got so creative. Alright. I know Kiwi's probably gonna get his ass kicked by the other two, but he needs this experience. There we go. See, the good thing is that Kiwi is getting just tons of experience. Daniel S. Bandicoot, does the S stand for skill issue? Man, you guys are mean. You guys are the reason I need therapy.
I told them to... Well... Pay for it, bitch. Also... also, fucking... I bully you excessively, and by the way... Why aren't we like, what during Cult of the Lamb?
Bullying me? Slug wants to see, like, violence during Cult of the Lamb and see me get, like, screwed over in the middle of everything. He's one of those gremlins that votes to try and, like, you know, fuck with me whenever there's a Twitch vote. Alright, that harpy's almost dead. Come on. Alright, Slade. If it's 8 damage. Aw, damn it. That's unfortunate. Really unfortunate. Okay, what's Blaze level 3? Ooh!
It's okay. Big, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a lot of damage. I like it.
That's a lot of damage.
Mm. The mage just tried bashing Kiwi with a stick. It did not work. Elf over here. Or hold over here. Sorry. Someone was asking me what I was doing. I'm like,
throw the link at them and just run.
I did. I was like bomb. I'm like, here's link streaming.
Just run. Wop wop wop
wop wop wop wop wop. Peter's still only earning 1 experience point because he's too strong. Gonna go up there to defend. Chester has range, I believe. Yeah, he still has range. I did keep that on him. Does anyone need healing right now? I think most people are topped off pretty good. Well, Peter's like, eh. Gonna... Perfect. May's also gonna go up here to be a defense. And Jaha, yeah. Jason's gonna stay. And Slade's gonna stab. Perfect. Yeah, everything's going well with this one. Oh, we have Kiwi basically on the verge of leveling up. Then that's gonna be 20.
Yeah, I mean, I honestly didn't think you were going to be able to milk that many levels into the poor little shit, but you've actually figured out power leveling pretty efficiently.
Yee. So here's the thing. I fuck up a lot when I'm learning something new. Like, an ungodly amount of fuck-ups. In the worst ways possible, usually.
That is how learning works, yes.
Exactly. Like, I just get all the failure out of the way early.
Mm-hmm. Nothing to worry about.
Slade is going places. Oh, yeah, he is. Yeah, we're gonna make a big rat. Very big rat. Jaha's gonna slap. This one finally took 2 hours. It's Shining Force 2! That's just how it is. These fights do take a while. And I'm a first-time player. Me just casually making every excuse in the book. When it all really just boils down to a skill issue.
It is not a skill issue.
Ah, come on.
A lot of it's RNG. Sometimes the AI can be really unpredictable.
You know what? You know what? I'm gonna try it. Damn. One of these times it'll work, probably. That should be the last one. Yay, we did it! Alright.
There you go.
I'm Elric, an archer. I had no idea how dangerous this pond was. You saved my life! Thank you!
You should thank Odler. He heard your cry for help and brought us here.
Oh well, it was nothing. An elf always returns a favor. Please, let me help you.
No, we're good.
Danny, looks like we found another friend.
You used the word friend, and I don't know if you realize what that word means.
Oh, thank you!
I didn't say you could join you.
Dandy, casually shitting on one of the statistically superior archers in the game.
He's an elf!
Let's go see Mr. Creed!
Elves!
Hey, Dandy. You know, it's funny. You've been doing nothing but shitting on that guy the whole time, not knowing Sarah is an elf.
I could tell. Didn't know your power friendship was so fucking racist. Listen, man, elves, as they're portrayed in most media, just piss me off. It's the same way I feel about angels, too. Like, it's always the people that are, like, all prissy and holier than thou, and they're like, oh, well, we live with nature, so we are clearly superior to you. Fuck off, you live in a tree. Like, why? Like, okay, treehouse was cool when you were, like, 10. Like, did elves just never grow up? Like, I don't know. Where am I going? Finally, someone played my favorite game, and it's not a speedrun. Oh, it's the opposite of a speedrun, man. This is a slow run.
Yeah.
I am not a... I'm very new to this game. Duga. Do I go up here?
Yeah, just talk to him and heal.
Yeah. Let's make... I don't think... Did anyone die? I didn't think anyone died. That's perfect. Just save. No one got poisoned either in that fight.
Yeah.
If you're new, search the bookshelves. Yeah, I've searched.
You searched all that stuff. All right, go back to where the little elf was.
Okay. No! No!
No! I did it! No! God damn it!
Take a shot, everybody!
I did so good last stream. I didn't do it. God damn it. Come on. Let me just get back into the game. God.
You guys don't understand. It's so easy for me to mash B to skip through dialogue. And on that one, if you mash B, pressing B actually takes you out of the game. Okay, we're back. We're back in. Okay, there we go. Also, hello, Hydra. Welcome. Okay, so I go out, I go to the left, yeah?
Yeah, back to where that pond was.
So you got Kazan's book. Yeah, we got that book. Wait, the pond? Wait.
Where you found Elric.
Oh, wait, so I have to go all the way back there? Oh, okay. Oops. Yeah, Ice Wolf here, the big, awesome wolf behind me, Duga, has played this game extensively and is making sure that I get all the secrets and stuff.
It's also so I can make fun of him when he fucks up.
Oh, yeah, it's a fuss.
Barry said move this rock in this manner, and... Got it! Thanks, Barry! Dandy, come on!
Okay, I guess he's kinda cool.
Stop. Look down. Stop. I said look down. God damn it, go left. Do you not see the little secret nugget to the left? Bottom down? It? Oh, a little lower. There you go, that was completely missable.
No, I just saw it, I just... who do we keep? Yeah, oh my god!
By the way, yeah, Elric isn't even in your battle party right now.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't need him if you
brave
don't.
Brave Apple! Alright, what's a Brave auto, Apple do?
Auto level up.
Oh. Should I use that on Kiwi? And just promote him?
Is he 20?
He's 19 right now. I use
you
that Apple.
Use it on, I mean, if you want to use it on him and then promote him, go for it.
Okay. Brave Apple.
Mm-hmm.
Be very careful this time. On Kiwi. Save it? Azzy is saying to save it.
Okay. I mean, you could listen to hold the guy on. Who's never played the game.
Hold on. No, I want to... Okay, everyone in chat who has played Shining Force 2, should I use the Apple on Kiwi right now, or should I save it? Because if I save it, it's like, when am I going to use it?
Exactly.
Kiwi, is he hungry? Sarah, she takes longer to level. That is a good point. She's only at 17.
Wait until Sarah gains a level, and when she's at 19, you can pop it on her. And when she gets up to 20, you can use the Master Monk thing and promote her.
Yeah.
She'll get the attack size and shit.
Okay. Yeah, and I think I already have 49 XP on Kiwi, so he just needs a couple more kills, and he's good. So, yeah, okay, we'll hold on to it. We'll use it for Sarah. That is a better idea, because she is much harder to level. Oh, God.
Sniff, sniff. I smell more invaders from the east. This is the territory of Mr. Creed.
I don't know what this voice is. I don't fucking know what I'm doing. Yeah. Go away!
We have to see him! Well, I'm looking at the wrong screen. I have, like, two menus up. We have to see him! Please, let us pass!
No. Leave now.
You're just a skeleton-looking clown! Eh. You're just a bunch of bones! Go away!
And you never know, mind. You know get him, boys!
You know how easy you are? You're just bones! There's nothing of substance to you! This is ridiculous!
Alright, what do we got here? Two orcs, a... What the fuck is it? A skeleton. Okay. Bony Maloney and the Spooky Boys. All right, we got another one of these. Priest, mage, skeleton, harpy, orc. God. This is so much brain power. Okay, obviously Gerhalt's gonna be a frontliner. Rick is kind of fucked. Can't really move him. Hey, Duga, thank you for following.
Hey, thanks, man.
Let's see. The calcium base frame by which your life meat hinges to, not unlike pizza dough clinging to coat hangers. Is that how you describe people? Also, Hydra, thank you for the follow, too. Are you winning, Dandy? You know what? I feel like I'm making progress, and that's all I can ask for right now. Alright, let's send God out there.
Oh, heck!
Having the centaurs so far back in the forest is just not fair.
Mm-hmm.
Keep Slay there. Kazan. There. It's kind of gonna. I wish. Gerhalt will move out here, try and bait some more in. Move myself down a little bit. Loop's gonna stay here, though. Rick's gonna get out. I actually like my formation right now. I think I'm doing good.
Mm-hmm.
Setting this up.
Yeah, you actually are, so.
Perfect. Peter's broken after he promotes. Dude, he's broken before he promotes. Like, he's ridiculous.
Isn't he, though?
Oh! Oh, I didn't restock on healing items. Shit.
Professional Jake and Ape, Daniel Bandicoot.
Hmm. Okay!
Dislocated hip, Daniel Bandicoot, realizing that skeletons can just disassemble themselves to dodge.
Yeah, apparently.
Thank you for not mentioning why I used dislocated hip to describe you.
Okay, that was only 2 damage. That's pretty lit, my fam.
So I'm going to need all of you guys to just, like, maybe punch him, like, square in the throat for that one. I know you can do it. I believe in you.
Are you going to be using the cursed weapons? I don't know what that means.
There are cursed weapons in the game. They're, like, really strong. They have this thing where they just kind of fucking curse you, and you can't do shit. Like, randomly. Huh.
Well, that sucks. You know what? I think. Yeah, this will be good. Who do I punch? Just half listening. I just want you to punch me because I said this is because this should be lit, my fam. We're gonna bring you back, Gerhalt. We're gonna do this to block them. Still attack this skeleton. Check your Discord, Dandy. Oh no. Hold on, what has he done? Is that... Jay repurposed a picture. Hold on. I don't think he's happy with the way I've been playing this game. Hold on.
Uh-oh.
And before I show this, Jay is a very close friend. He and I have made jokes about stuff like this before because we shitpost back and forth and sometimes like, no, you need to be punished for that shitpost. But here, I'm about to put this on stream. I just need to arranging something.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, so I think he's, I don't know, but I think Jay is not happy with the way I have been playing this game. Oh my gosh.
You know, for a minute there, I was thinking, like, he would have drawn me beating the crap out of you, but the fact that he's just drawn you dead on the ground next to a Sega Genesis, bleeding uncontrollably while he beats you within an inch of your life is kind of perfect, honestly.
Fucking love it. Wait, I didn't see it. Hold on. Okay, let me... There it is. Wait, did you just draw that? So Atomico, this... This is a pose he has drawn before. He just added the fucking computer and the Sega Genesis there.
It's nice to know that his desire to harm you is something that just kind of stays with him.
To be fair, I deserve it. I forget what prompted that picture in the first place, but I remember it was something extremely cursed. And he was just like, that's it. We go back and forth. It's fine. It's all in jest. That smiling guy's clip you shit. I don't even remember, dude. Also, Luke is hurting.
Yeah.
One with a lollipop. Okay, that's ringing some bells. But not, like, all the bells. Uh-oh. Hey, Aki, welcome to the chat. Beating the shit out of the skeleton. Come on, will you die already? Damn it. Oh, wait. We're gonna do Blaze 3 on this motherfucker. How's it going, everyone? It's going good! This has been a very chaotic night, though. Extremely chaotic.
Knuckles chaotic. Oh, no, sorry. No.
Knuckles chaotic. You know, that is one Sonic game I've actually never played.
That is why you still have some friends.
Dropped a broadsword. Okay. Cool.
Yeah, free broadsword.
Oh, hey! Peter's getting experience again. Uh-oh. Oh, Luke! Oh, that's a good dodge! That's a really fucking good dodge! Oh, baby!
It's normally dodges like that where they fail to dodge and wind up eating shit anyways, so...
Go.
Oh, man, look at how happy everybody in chat is.
Yeah. Alright, Jaha's gonna go on this side. Smack the crap out of it. Yeah, boy! Broadsword is for promos, you can't use it until then. I mean, that's fine. Are you guys roleplaying as characters from the game? I mean...
What?
When there's cutscenes. Like, we'll put on voices and stuff.
Yeah, we read the dialogue and shit.
But, like, the whole time? No, not really. I mean, I named the main character after myself, but...
And Gerhalt looks eerily like me when he's promoted. What a coincidence.
Oh, the character in the bottom right? No, we're furries, dude!
We're furries, man. This is just us.
Yeah. And this is what we look like normally.
Yeah.
What's your voice for Slade?
Didn't I give him like a cool voice like this or something?
Mm-hmm.
Yup.
Yeah, I kinda sorta fucked up the entire world, but you know, I'm trying to atone for it.
Yeah, he sounds like that one guy that you grew up with that like had all the fucking various edgy band stickers all over his everything. And he wore the baggy black pants and way too much black.
Listen.
And he always had headphones on or earbuds in.
Listen, man, My Chemical Romance is fucking great. Don't you be dissing the trip pants either.
Struggling artist Daniel Bandit, yes! Losing friends. There we go.
One HP! Kiwi, do your thing! Aw, Gerhalt. Ugh, Gerhalt needs to be stayed back here and heal, actually. Does he have healing drop? He does. Oh, but Luke. Oh, God. You know what? Gerhalt's gonna use it on himself. He's a selfish bitch like that. No, he's not. Funny promote, but 40 is max for unpromoted and 99 for promoted. Yeah. But apparently for a lot of characters, better to promote at 30 than it is 20.
Yep, it is. But here's the thing. There's no right or wrong way to play the game.
Yeah. I mean, I am absolutely just like bungling it at every turn and somehow still, you know, getting it taken care of. The game is balanced so that you can win handily just promoting at 20, though. First of all, welcome to the chat, Onward. Second of all, I like being overpowered as shit in RPGs. Like, I'm the kind of person that uses the mush badge on Mario & Luigi RPG Superstar
Saga. What the fuck does that do?
It basically increases your attack for every mushroom you have in your inventory. And it counts regular mushrooms, super mushrooms, ultra mushrooms, max mushrooms, one-up shrooms, and super one-up shrooms. So you just stack a whole bunch of mushrooms in your inventory, and you can literally one-shot the final boss. That's not an exaggeration.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the first Mario & Luigi RPG game is horrendously imbalanced. They fixed it for the remake, but oh man, it's fucking funny. Yeah, Kiwi can be promoted. I'm gonna promote Kiwi before the end of stream if we have the ability to do that. Like we just promoted the like church, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna do that as soon as we can then. Sounds like a game you can stream at some point. I would enjoy streaming that. I did play it a little bit ago, so it's like, I gotta wait probably like a year or two before I get, you know, back into wanting. Get the mood back to play that again.
Wasn't that the one Delta wanted to do?
Delta wanted to do Super Paper Mario. He does like the Mario & Luigi RPG games, though. Super Mario RPG, I would absolutely play because I haven't ever beaten it.
Oh.
But yeah, Super Paper Mario is something that I'd want to do on stream. There's a lot I want to do on stream, dude. But a lot of them are single player games. I'm like, we gotta do some co-op sometime.
Well, you know, it's up to you if you want to do co-op. You don't have to, by any means.
It's a... I mean, all the times we... Oh my god, another one that's just at 1 HP. This one I might give to Sarah. Yeah, Sarah, you're gonna get some experience for once.
The same way everyone else does, through violence. Even though she has Blast and could be casting it this whole fucking time.
She could. There we go, level 18. There's a game, but the story is top tier. Super Paper Mario, that is. Yeah, the action platforming they did was interesting. I see what they were going for, but... Eh. You can always play Left 4 Dead 2 and give us a reason to kill you.
That's brutal. God. Don't you feel love, Dandy?
I feel all the love from my chat. Best retro co-op game: Secret of Mana, Seiken Densetsu 3, Legend of the Mystical Ninja, Pocky Rocky 1 and 2. Those are all solid games. None of which I've played, but they are solid games from what I have seen. Nintendo just needs to acknowledge that Geno exists. I don't think Square Enix lets them acknowledge it. I think that's the problem. Goemon, I have seen before. I think I messed around with it on the Virtual Console once or twice. What am I doing? There's mages over there. Ooh, Kiwi getting some damage now. Fucking Rocky is hard as hell. I've heard that it is. You know what? I'm trying to think of, like, co-op games that would be, like, really good to do on stream. Like,
I don't know.
Because there's a lot that we play, but...
There are many games that are good co-op games that could be played.
Yeah, it's just a lot of the ones that we do are, like, usually, like, open world survival. I don't know how streamable those usually are. River City Girls! Ooh.
No.
Never. No? I've heard that one's good.
River City Ransom Underground is actually really good, though.
I've heard nothing but good things about the River City series in general.
Yeah, I just don't like the gimmick of the River City Girls.
Ah, fair.
Fun fact, based on the amount of testosterone-laden Neanderthals that I draw, I don't really vibe super great when I have to play as a chick in a game.
That's fair. I don't know. I don't care as long as the character's awesome. Like, if they do the character, like, badass, that's all I really require for my action games. Also, my god, another one that's at one, but this is a healer, so, eh. Wizard with a gun? I'm sorry, what? What is this? Demo doesn't have co-op yet. Oh, but, I mean, that... I'm entranced by just the name alone, though.
Oh my god, Jay, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Wait, what did he do?
Jay Show Dandy.
Hold on, wait. Okay, Slay's about to get his shit pushed in, but apparently Jay has done another thing. What is this? Hold on. Alright, we're gonna just pause for a second so I can pull up this picture. Remember earlier when we were talking about Ice being like this giant hulking macro wolf, whispering Poyo very softly and stuff? Sorry, it's taking a little bit here to... Taking a moment here to... Oh, this is gonna be... I'll have to do some stuff with it, but... There we go! Here, I'm gonna zoom in on it. Here we go. There he is. There's the big ice wolf. He goes, Poyo. And there goes the house. Just crushes the shit out of it. Oh, God. That's fucking...
It's beautiful. Poyo. It's beautiful. You have to fucking post that on Twitter.
Oh, there's a lot I gotta post on Twitter, apparently. Also, Newmar, thank you for the yet another gift sub, man. You're fucking insane. Kiwi is not gonna just go face to face with a fucking mage. That's just a bad idea. Peter, on the other hand, will scream this mage's skin off. Oh my god! No, he absolutely will! At least with a Poyo, not in a woo. God, the way that Ice does woos is just like, ugh.
It will.
I hate how good that is. We're just gonna blast this harpy and just see how much damage it does. That's alright. It's decent. Get some experience. And Mei's gonna get the experience from killing the priest. I take a little sippy. What? I gotta remember. Alright, this should roast this.
I noticed that the hydrate meme is just like everybody's thing. It's weird to me.
Yeah, I mean, I keep a water bottle on my desk while I stream because my mouth gets dry talking for so long. So it's not hard to remember to hydrate when it's like I can feel how dry my mouth is getting.
Yeah.
I start moving people in for the final battle with these guys. I want to just... Luke doesn't have items, so he's going to go by the healer. I don't need a heal, I'm good. Priest. Heal. Heal Luke. There we go, that's good. Peter can use some health. Does he have an item still? He do.
I can taste blood in my mouth!
Ah, he's only got like half health. That's fine. Oh my god, excuse me.
The fuck was that sound?
That was a burp. Alright, he was gonna start advancing.
Yeah, notice, sand is really rough to move in. Don't do it.
Oh god, speaking of rough, Vaughn.
Sorry, babe.
God. Healing drop on Kazen. Kazen needs it. I'm actually using my items and being good.
Professional Twitch streamer Daniel Bandicoot thinking that wasting his items when they're not necessary is a brilliant plan.
It's not waiting.
I didn't say waiting, now did I?
I meant to say wasting. I don't know why I said waiting. Oh, my brain. Oh my god, he's running away.
Wouldn't you?
I mean, yeah, if I saw all these people like running towards me, I'd be a little scared. Yeah, we're good. Oh yeah, that's a juicy crit. Damage on me, though.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, Peter can't get in close enough. Shoot. Okay, but May can get some damage in. That was a crit. Ugh. I mean, like, Skeleton probably is going to take much from piercing damage. Oh my god, probably. Please, can Kazen get in there? Please tell me Kazen can get in there, because that's going to be beautiful for like a Blaze 3 setup. Oh god, not even close. But I'm going to try and keep him busy here, so we can just roast him alive on some point. Kazen is going to need to stand there, so... But look, Luke here. Move Chester back here to attack the High Priest.
Very good.
That way the priest is going to heal himself instead of the enemies.
He's learning, guys! Fucking brilliant. Yes. Can be taught. Sometimes.
Oh, the counterattack. Oh. Well, yeah, that... unfortunately, I had a feeling that was gonna happen. You allow that? I had a feeling it was gonna happen. I didn't want it to happen. I just thought it was going to. Also, I'm just putting I'm putting Peter here as a power play.
Okay.
Because I kind of want them to all, like, you know, turn on him and attack him, because he's not going to take any damage.
Well, he's going to take damage, just, you know, not a ton.
You know what? Guacamole with banana on bread is tasty. You know, I'd be willing to try it at least once.
But for somebody who wants to consume mush with mush on mush, it's a fantastic idea.
Hmm.
By the way, I've got when you're introduced to a character called Creed, I have it taken care of for voice.
Oh, okay. Gonna keep attacking the priest.
Do it.
Hey, Luke's 23 now.
Yep. Well done.
We're gonna unalive the skeleton.
Ah, using your YouTube terms, I see.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, I just think unalive is kind of a more brutal, like, way to put it than kill for some reason. I don't know, just like, oh, that was the boss.
Yeah.
Oh. Hurry, let's go into Creed's mansion.
Butler, can you see?
No, why?
You're moving around like you can see.
Am I? Maybe my other senses have sharpened since I lost my sight.
see. Andy, let's go see Mr. Creed.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, this music's really happy. This must be a nice place.
Hold on a second. Let me do my thing here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I got a whole thing for it.
Oh, okay. All right. I will wait. Hi, chat. How you doing? This dude.
You may go now. I need to talk to the fairy.
Yes, sir.
Dum-de-dum-dum. Oh, time to check your collections.
Servant Goliath unlocks the door.
Excuse me?
No! Yes?
Bet you've never seen a magical talking phoenix before. We've come to see Mr. Creed.
My master? Do you have an appointment?
A what?
No, we don't, no.
No, not yet, but,
I'm sorry, bud, he's busy now. Please come back later.
We can't see Mr. Creed now?
No kidding. Dandy, Peter, let's force our way into the room.
Oddler, you're getting bold! But, it is a good idea.
After seeing you guys beat the shit out of a few things, I kind of want to get in on the violence.
You can't see! Let's go!
Oh yes, that's right, I can't see, can't see.
Holy shit, how did he do that?
You impolite kids, you can't go in. Mr. Creed is too busy, go away!
Dandy on our left, that door might lead to Mr. Creed! Let's ditch this guy and go through that door!
Dandy, let's do it. I don't want to fail now.
Okay, we give up! We'll see Mr. Creed later. Let's get out of here.
Yeah, maybe later.
That moment when you realize the main character is the only not murder hobo in the party.
No, don't go in there. That door is...
Oh, shoot!
What stupid kids. Whoever passes through this magic door becomes small. That is, anybody who's not protected by Mr. Creed.
Goliath picks up Dandy. Oh, God.
Now you're part of the collection.
The what? Oh, come on. Oh, come on.
What happened? Strange feeling swept over me when I entered that door. Then it felt like I was lifted upward.
It's very difficult to explain what's happened to us. Anyways, we're very small now.
Oh god, Dandy, run! The jar! Don't even joke!
Well, how small?
Well, I see a little plastic unicorn over there in a cup. Let's see, we're on a desk and it's very large, like a village.
Exactly.
Goliath! Hey, what did you do to us?
Told you not to go in there. You didn't listen to my warning. You guys look so cute. Bye, little kitties.
Oh, they changed the pitch to make it sound like the footsteps were getting further away. That's cute.
Dandy, cheer up! Let's look around this desktop kingdom.
I agree. We can meet Creed later.
All right.
Are you from the outside? Why did you come here? Ah, mistake. I see. I suggest you see King Pompey. He's a good man.
Also, that character kicks unreasonable amounts of ass, just so you know.
Oh, God.
That's Karna. So you're going to meet four characters in here. You're going to, by the time the sequence is over, be allowed to choose one of them to come with you. Then, later on in the game, you can come back here and gather the other three. But there's one of each four classes, so this is the only way you can get your second healer this early in the game.
This kingdom was made by greed. This concept of time here, we never get old. Except for me. We never die. What is the meaning of life? Game?
He's a fine gentleman. His magic saved us a long time ago during a natural disaster.
Devils cannot use their magic to affect human lives. Supposedly it's one of their rules.
Sting?
Halt! I can't let you pass without the king's permission.
Oh, fuck. That's a chessboard, isn't it?
Yep.
That's kind of suspicious how all those chess pieces are moving, isn't it?
Yeah, we're gonna have to fight a fucking chess game, and I'm very, very happy about that.
You probably want to promote some characters and potentially save this ball buster of a fight for next time. I'm not
sure. Well, yeah, it's just where's Priest?
You mean the priest standing on that book right fucking there next to the caravan that is now shrunk down even smaller than before?
Yeah, got it.
Dandy, you're... Oh, fuck. Dandy, okay, bye.
This army is very strong. It'll be good training for you.
Alright. Raise everyone. Alright, and then we're gonna promote Kiwi. Yes, the desire. Promote. Who do you want to promote? Alright, so we can just promote Kiwi just right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Kiwi wants to be promoted to the A fighting class. To the A fighting class.
Uh-huh.
Oh,
enjoy
God.
Enjoy that fantastic bit of a translation.
Kiwi can be promoted to Munst. A minister?
Sure.
A Mountain Dew. He can be promoted to a Mountain Dew. Awesome. Now let me conduct the rite. The light blesses. Fort Kiwi. Fortia Kiwi. With a class of Mountain Dew. He's gone from tortilla to Mountain Dew, you guys!
Why is my pain eternal?
Yay. Kiwi was successfully promoted to Mountain Dew. Monster energy. He's an energy drink now. Woo! Oh my god, he looks awesome. Look at him! Yo! He looks so cool! Now, Ice, I'm gonna ask you. Before this fight, should... Oh, well, she's level 18, not 19 yet. Okay, so never mind. That's awesome. Oh, I'm wrong. Do you have another desire? Yes, I would like... to save. And record your adventure now. Yes. You should farm. I should. I will see if I have time to. I will try my best. I make no promises. The light allows you to resume your adventure. Will you continue your adventure? Nah. I think we're gonna call it there for tonight, so. Give me 1 second here, guys. To see Peter promoted. Oh, I'm excited. I'm very excited for that.
I'm gonna drop his voice a pitch when he gets promoted too, because he turns into like a Fabio hunk.
Yeah. Let me see. I'm seeing if there's anyone on my follow list that is still streaming that we can raid. Ice, do you know any new people that would want to raid right now? I'm currently not seeing anyone.
Yeah, I know one.
Alright. Toss me the name. And while you're getting that, I'm gonna click over to the credits here. So that we can thank all of the lovely, wonderful people, in the audience here. Thank you to the subs. Thank you to the new followers. Thank you to, everyone. And, oh my god, hold on. Of course, it's gonna glitch up, so I have to refresh it twice. But yeah, thanks guys. If you stick around for just a second here, we can keep the party going. Ice is gonna get us the name of someone we can raid. But yeah, seriously, thank you everyone. And actually, before we close out, I guess, anyone got any last minute first pictures relating to Shining Force or anything like that I could throw up on the screen? here we go. Ice has just given me
I sent it to you.
Yep. And there's Kallus. Kallus Dragon. He is playing... What is he playing? He's playing Tears of the Kingdom right now.
He's an Inflato Dragon.
Ooh, Inflato Dragon. I do like the Inflatos. Alright. So, Tears of the Kingdom is what he's playing. Looks like he's pretty far in the game, so...
Yep, just raid him.
Yep. Here we go. Let's go see some Tears of the Kingdom gameplay, guys. Here we go. Thank you again for a wonderful night, guys. Take care and have a good one.